I'm in the Faculty of Engineering, Computing and Mathematics at the University of Western Australia. I teach the unit Data Collection and Analysis, which is a Level 3 unit for engineering science students who are progressing to master's degrees in either environmental engineering or mining engineering. The focus of the unit is providing students with the basic tools that they need to collect, to analyse and to interpret data to describe complex natural systems. In this unit, I use team-based learning, which is an alternative to lecture-based instruction. The basis of team-based learning is that classes are spent with the students working in teams on complex and ill-structured problems.
The entire unit, I think there's only one project that is individual, everything else is group, and there's no exam, so it's all really heavily group-based.
At the start of the module, he gave us some pre-reading to do, and he gave us, he called it a readiness assurance test, which is a multi-choice test you do individually.
Okay, so what we'll do is we'll start the test now. 20 minutes to do it individually, then get these things
through. We do an assessment on our own, and then we do the exact same assessment, same questions, same everything as a group, and we see whether the group performed better than the individuals, and we can kind of get feedback on what questions we got wrong and figure out why the group worked worse or worked better than the best person in our group, if that makes sense.
You use these scratch cards so you know if you got it right or not in your team, so you get the answers to the test straight away.
So the class goes for an hour and a half, I guess it is, the two slots. For the first half hour, he would chat up right on the board and be like, this is this thing you need to be focusing on today. And we have a question that proves that, it goes for an hour. So yeah, and he's always walking around chatting as well, but he tries to keep lecturing to a minimum, I guess, which is good.
What are the advantages of this curfew relative to the students?
Yes, through the origin.
Oh, so the origin, yeah, absolutely.
Some lecturers have a tendency to just give you so many notes that aren't really relevant, and then some just talk and you don't write anything down and you don't learn anything. So I think it's got a good mix there as well.
Like some lecturers go, this is the way we're doing things, if it doesn't work out, too bad. Whereas he's very open to discussion and feedback. He works through to make sure that you're actually progressing and that your team is functioning.
One of the reasons I like team-based learning is that it certainly promotes active learning in the classroom. The benefit of team-based learning is really that if I have 40 students, I have 40 teachers in the room at any given time. And students learn a great deal from their peers rather than just from me.
So the group work is allocated at random, but when he allocates them, he got us to line up in terms of our skills. So that means that every group's got someone who can use a computer really well, someone who's from a mathematical background, someone from a scientific background, and it makes everything a lot easier.
In this film, I've shown you how I use team-based learning in my teaching. I use it because it promotes active learning in the classroom, and it also enhances the extent to which students attain the learning outcomes of this unit. If you have any interest in using team-based learning, learning how it works, any interest in either problem-based learning or collaborative learning, please feel free to contact me.